This one's called Wall of Flesh. A single rock and roll song clutched in their hands, dancing in a spasm, fitful and pleasured. White bright noise. She doesn't speak anymore, just a silent grin. Mrs. Sardonicus has come to rest at the base of a bridge. Swaying in the December heat, New York City won't forgive, and her children eating their children never forget. That's how it happened. That's why it happened. Leather jackets and foam from her unforgiving mouth as she is strapped to a Harley that is out of sync and out of gas. Bloody boots tell them of her commitment. Motor humming frozen behind Marilyn Monroe's eyes, lined with mascara, a pained disease. Silent desires never heard, Jane Mansfield's car in pieces, behind the glass, silent corpses bound in leather and newsprint, playing excessive tiredness, finally stole the preconsciousness, promiscuous and silent. A fugitive from the long mirror, January 1st, 2016, 3 o'clock a.m. I think I'm sick and I want to go home. It's true. I always feel more comfortable in the flicker of a screen, door behind me shut, 4x4 space muffled outside sounds, enclosed in a box. Source of strength from lonesome looks, hazy recollections of successful assassinations, squirming in the theater underneath, layers of minds and layers of vacant smiles. I'm supposed to surrender to a world of pain to become a shocked figure in the glare. There were fakers that kissed the slaves from hell, condemned to remain by ourselves. Identity reinserted, turned inside out. Peel off the future and re-examine the past. Pulling down the bad thoughts. Submission is almost never the way home. From here, she magically removed vulnerabilities. Their purpose was masochistic tendencies, subconsciously pushing their agendas. Things didn't look too promising for our heroine. She had qualms about living unhindered, splitting the atom to her taste and for her waste. The profound clocks incorporating straight razors, hidden faces in each seat of the abandoned movie theater, waiting for the stroke of midnight when all will be erased, Cinderella's infernal rebirth. Under your eyelids, we will taste the touches of frightened screamers. What have you done to me? My senses have been enhanced. What are the words that I crave? Raise my eyes, leave the basement. Fears were created in our own image by her own hands. She would kill an hour or two, but not in good company. You were resolved by the ghosts of faces. She enjoyed peculiar kissing once or twice, but soon she was overcome by sleep and darkness. Answered and punished by dire consequences, a prisoner of her own myth she wanted to run. Thank you.